Depends on the person. Are they a beginner? If they're a beginner, hardcore, never done it, never, I usually tell them to start off with 3 days a week. Then, as the weeks come, we'll increase to 4, once a day. Then we'll get into 5, then we can get into 6. Always leave a day, at least a day or two, to let the body rest. Overtraining. You push the body too far, too much throughout the week, you don't give it time to recover, it's never gonna change. You're never gonna get to your goal because you're not allowing the body to rest and allow those muscles to recover. So on average, if I have somebody who I know who's pretty athletic and works out, I'll tell them 5-6 times a day, once a day, an hour and a half, hour. You can do a 2-hour workout, 30 minutes. It's all about intensity. You know, it's just like, well, I have people who are like businessmen or women, working moms, they don't have an hour and a half to work out. Sometimes they can't get in but 3-4 times a week. So what I do is I take their workouts and I condense them. So, okay, you're only gonna be able to give me a half hour a day? Okay. 30 minutes of pure work. You know, short recoveries, but you're getting that same amount that you would in that 2-hour frame, just condensed in that 30-minute frame. Right. Setting the expectations too high, too early. That's the biggest thing. I've trained with so many people. I want to drop 20 pounds in 2.5 weeks. I'm like, no. I want to drop 30 pounds in 2 months. I'm like, that's doable. It's difficult, but it's doable. So setting your expectations reasonable. So, okay, hey, my goal for this week is to do this. Go to the gym every day or every other day. Eat clean. Start there. Then build your expectations. Okay, I want to lose 5 pounds in the next 2 weeks. Start there. You hit your 5 pounds. Okay, I want to lose more. The expectation is probably one of the biggest things. And then follow behind expectations is correct form. Correct form is probably the number one killer of most people in the gym because people get hurt. You don't do correct form, let alone not get the body you want, you can really hurt yourself. A lot of the stuff in the gym, your back. Once your back is gone, you're done. You know, I've had back injuries. That's 6 months. Depending on how active you are, that's 4 months. I mean, you know, correct form is one of the things I teach the most. I'd rather a client go slow and we have to take a little bit longer, but I'd rather have them do it correct form. This keeps them doing it correct. This keeps me working the right muscles, and it keeps them from getting hurt. They get hurt, one of two things can happen. I lose a client. Well, actually, I'll lose the client. But then she doesn't get her goals, and she could sue me, or she could sue my company.
And the word of mouth.
Yeah, and then the word of mouth goes up. That's even more detrimental. The suing, all that, that happens. But when that word of mouth goes out, people are going to believe 10 negative things before they believe one positive thing about you. And I've watched trainers destroy their careers out here. You know, just not doing things the right way. Get a bad reputation. That's all you need. I've worked 15 years to build my reputation, so I make sure I do everything correct. I don't lie to my clients, realistic. I give them the truth. They may not like it, but I didn't lie to them. The first week is what I call hell week. When you're just starting out, you just have to understand, you're gonna be sore because it's new to the body. So the body has to adjust. It has to, you know, all those muscles are being, what happens when you work out? You tear muscle, little small little micro tears. And then it heals and it comes back stronger. So, you know, that's where all that soreness comes from. So one of the first things, once you get really, really sore, stretch. Then after stretching, maybe do a little light massaging, some ice on the muscles. Ice at the end of the day, maybe some heat early in the day to kind of get the blood flowing there, get some stretching, jogging. Believe it or not, when I used to train for the Olympics, when we were really sore, our coach would just send us for like a 2-mile jog. We're like, coach, we just said our legs hurt. Go for a jog. But the next day you feel great. You know, it just kind of just breaks up all that and just helps loosen it up a little bit. And then stretching, get some ice in there in the muscles, and just, you know, also be sure you're having a good diet. Hydration. If you're not very well hydrated, the muscles can't get the, get any water. So you definitely want the stretching, hydration, good nutrition, throw some ice on there here and there. The first week is rough. It's rough for everybody. Oh man, we could even go into supplements. That's a whole big conversation. Like, they'll take supplements before they take water. But then a lot of that stuff, it'll dehydrate you. Creatine will dehydrate you. That's what it says it does. That's why they said you have to load X amount of water when taking creatine. And then you got to keep that going throughout the day, probably about a gallon or more a day, within the first 4, 5 to 7 days. Like, people don't read. You got to read supplements. And then next thing you know, they're even more dehydrated than it started. Or they'll take the supplements inside of a whole bunch of water, but it's kind of like a give-take type deal.
Thank you for watching A Wise Way. Subscribe to stay updated, share to pass the knowledge, or view our other videos on the left.